So we are here basically to talk to you and your team about the Violence Against Persons Prohibition Bill, which is supposed to be before the Sokoto State House of Assembly. And that bill is not only for the protection of the girl, child and women, it's also for the protection of every member of society, including the males. Essentially, we have a constitution which has talked about the right to personal dignity, human dignity, in section 34. But there is no way any citizen of Nigeria can be said to be enjoying his human dignity if he's still subject to violence against his person. Now, Nigeria, as a member of the civilized community, has ratified several treaties at the level of the United Nations and also at the level of the African Union. Key among which is the Convention on the Elimination of All Forms of Discrimination Against Women, and also the Protocol to the African Charter on Human and People's Rights on the Rights of Women in Africa. And all of them have defined very key issues that they want to see outlawed, that they don't want to see continuing, as well as identified issues they want to see should be the position of men, women in society on the basis of non-discrimination. Happily, there is a bill before the Sokoto State House of Assembly which is already talking about violence against persons. We are here to seek your collaboration on a number of issues. Well, the media, as you very well know, you have a constitutional duty to hold the government accountable to the people. You also have that duty to set agenda on key issues, bring key issues to the front burner of national discourse, and help shape public opinion. So one is that the bill before the State House of Assembly needs fine-tuning to make sure that it's in accordance with fit and good practices, contextualize it within Sokoto State. Even if it passes through the State House of Assembly, it still needs the assent of His Excellency the Governor. If His Excellency gives assent, it still needs to be explained to the people. The world is sensitized so that nobody runs afoul of the law claiming ignorance, although ignorance is no excuse, but it is important that everybody knows what the context of a law is, what is good and what is right and what is forbidden. So that's essentially what brings us here. Also considering that we did some studies in the past which also showed that there are quite a number of challenges relating to issues around sexual and gender-based violence. We looked at this and the budget from 2016 to 2019. And it also showed that comparatively to other states, there are quite a lot of challenges and gaps in Sokoto State which need to be filled. And FAP is one of those recommendations that I made here. And we will be very happy and excited to say in the next 6 months that Sokoto State had passed their FAP bill. I was just relating to my colleagues who were in Adamawa State last week, and they just called us to say, oh, that they have simply, the House of Assembly have passed their own FAP bill, which is quite some good news. And so that Sokoto State will join other states who have already started moving. And you can see a lot of international partners and donors are interested in this, in the sense that they believe that this is one key area that will help the state move on to the next level of achievement. So I want to thank you for the opportunity you've given to us and say we can collaborate and do more. Thank you.